Funeral for a Friend haben sich in mehr als 13 Jahren Bandgeschichte schon öfter die Bühne mit Boys Sets Fire geteilt und spielen heute auch hier beim Family First Festival. Und Matt ist jetzt hier bei mir. Matt, how does it feel playing tonight with old friends?
It feels great. We rarely get to do it often, so when it does get to happen, it's a lot of fun.
And do you remember the first time you met Boys Sets Fire?
Quite vividly. It was pretty much like a party. I mean, we played 4 shows with them in the UK in 2002. And from that period, I think we struck a strong friendship bond. And it took us a long time to get to work out another tour and stuff. So, they've always been very close to us and us to them. So it's nice to be invited here to be a part of this.
You said that your latest album is more influenced by your punk and hardcore background than all your other records before.
Yeah.
Would you say it's also influenced by Boys Sets Fire, or perhaps kind of a monument of your friendship?
I mean, I've always been inspired by Boys Sets Fire. I mean, Nathan, before I even got to know them and got to play with them, they were always one of my main influences that drove me to want to be in a band, that drove me to wanted to write personal and important kind of messages in my lyrics and things. So for me, this new record is, I mean, it's kind of like paying respect to that influence a little bit, you know, maybe not musically all the time, but definitely in the sensibility of the passion they instilled in me when I first heard their records. So very much so.
Are you setting yourself a goal, what you want to achieve with the sound of a new album?
Not really. I mean, for us, I think it was a case of, you know, album number 7, let's just break it down to the bare basics of what we really love about music, that, you know, and the influences and what we kind of, what gets us off creatively. And I think having a record that is as raw and as passionate as Chapter and Verse was a testament, I think, to our ideal of being a band and being able to pull it off in a live environment without having to rely on computers to do the work, you know, so like a lot of bands do these days.
Yeah. So how do you keep the passion going over years?
By having fun and generally not giving a crap about what people think about you. It's kind of selfish to say that, but I think it's the real reason why we've still been able to have a lot of fun doing this, because, you know, otherwise, if you start thinking about other people, your audience, what the fans want, then I kind of think it takes the responsibility that you have as an artist, as a creative individual, away from you. And I think we've always been pretty selfish in that regard, that the art always comes first and the message always comes first, and whatever people think about the music comes second.
You said once that you're kind of a weekend warrior now.
Yeah, I mean, as we've gotten older and we have like responsibilities and families and things, it's harder for us to be away for longer periods of time. Like we used to when we were younger, we'd be away for like 8 or 9 months out of the year touring. Now it's we do like one big tour when the album comes out for like maybe a month, and then we kind of do like, you know, weekend shows here and there for the next 6 or 7 months. So it allows us to spend time with family and dedicate time to that part of our lives, which is equally as important to us now as making music and playing shows and getting to meet people.
So you grew up in South Wales,
yep.
And how did it influence your music?
For me, I mean, musically, maybe not as much as what it affected me in terms of my outlook, in terms of how it affected my lyric writing. And the reason probably why I ended up being very much drawn to bands like Boys Sets Fire, because I come from a very working class family, we all do. We come from a very poor part of the UK. And seeing the everyday struggles of, you know, lower class, middle class, working class people, what our families had to endure growing up in the late 70s, early 80s, it just fed into our kind of social makeup quite a lot. And maybe we didn't realize that till much later on in our lives. But for me, it's always been some kind of social commentary that has always filtered into my words over the years. I guess that's the biggest influence that I've pulled from it, is just seeing the refusal of the communities to give up in the face of adversity and hardship and economic difficulties and social difficulties.
Do you listen to any drum bands?
I listened to some really good friends of ours in a band called The Tidal Sleep, mm-hmm. Who we absolutely adore. And if we could play with any band right now for the rest of our lives, I think it would be them, because we have such a strong, like Boys to Fire, we have such a strong friendship and a strong bond with those guys.
How do you met them?
A friend of mine, I mean, the thing is, back home, there's a very strong kind of underground hardcore scene. And a friend of ours produced one of their records. And for some kind of strange coincidence, they were recommended to me by a work colleague of my wife, who's also German. And she co-owns an agency called Avocado Booking. And they basically I had a link to listen to them, and I just fell in love. And it was the kind of music that I kind of grew up listening to and really was very passionate about. And for me, when we started playing shows, coming back on an album cycle to play shows on the mainland, they were like, we want to play shows with those guys, and they agreed. They were fans, which is cool, and they're awesome guys.
You said you don't like playing big arenas, right?
I've always this is going to sound maybe weird to people who know the band, but I've always felt uncomfortable playing big stages. I'm a little bit worried about the size of the stage in this place, because the last time we played here was when we supported My Chemical Romance, like back in 2007. So I had flashbacks when I was walking in.
But why is it so?
I just kind of think I like intimate places where I can kind of feel up close to people. And sometimes I'm always fearful of that connection being taken away or stretched too far. But we try our best to kind of to make a small club show happen in a big venue sometimes. So
would you say it's important for a band to support their local scene?
Yeah, very much so. I think especially in the UK right now, a lot of venues are starting to close down, which is incredibly sad and really leaves the state of the scene of music in a bit of a difficult place, because, you know, I'm sure bands will find new places to play and things, but it'd be nice to have the support of your local kind of councils and your government to help encourage people and the youth to channel their energy into something like music, into playing shows and being creative in that regard, because there's not a lot for kids to do back home. So
you will be on stage with Boys That's Fire tonight, right?
I think so. I think I've been told
you don't know it
I've
yet?
Been told that I've been invited up to play. So yeah, that's a bit nerve-wracking. I've done it a bunch of times, but to actually be properly invited up, I've just kind of run up and just grabbed the microphone before, but this is like, you've been invited to sing with Boys to Fire. And it's not a big deal.